In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a grayscale image from a full color image using Photoshop, and then how to convert that grayscale to a duotone image in which you can create a simulated one color image. So the first thing that I'm going to do is go to the image menu, choose mode, and check the current color mode that we're in. So currently this is an RGB color mode. Let's go ahead and just change that to grayscale. And now we have a grayscale image. If you want to make your image look a little bit richer than this, you can duplicate the layer and then choose multiply for the blend mode. And then you can adjust the opacity of the top layer. Now that we have our grayscale image, we can go a step further and convert this image to a one color or monotone image. When I say one color or monotone, I'm talking about a color other than grayscale. So we do need to start with a grayscale image and then go to image mode, choose duotone. And by default, there should be a monotone type, which means there's a single ink color in here. If we were to go to duotone, we could choose two different ink colors, but let's stick with monotone for now. And since we have a grayscale image, grayscale is based on black. So we have a black ink color preset in ink one. So let's just go ahead and choose a custom ink color. I'm going to click on the swatch and get our color picker. And let's say I want a red color. Then I can just choose red. Or if I want a blue color, I can use the slider to choose different colors. But I'm going to stick with red for now. And I'm going to hit OK. Let's say that you decided that you really wanted a different color instead of the red that you chose before, then you could just click on the swatch and you could choose a different red or choose a different color entirely. But I'm going to keep my red color. Another option is to use a custom preset. So there are some custom colors that are already pre-installed. And if I was to decide that instead of this red that I chose, instead of using the color picker, I wanted to use one of these custom colors, what happens is it adds that as a second ink color rather than replacing my first ink color. So now I have a duotone image. So what I'm going to do is I really want to stick with my monotone image. I'm going to hold Option and choose Reset. And that's Option on the Mac, it's Alt on a PC. And then I'm going to go ahead and choose my original red that I would like. And then I'm going to click OK. Oops, I need to name my ink, so I need to name it something. I'll just name it red and hit OK. So now I have a one-color red pizza. The thing about this single color is that to me it looks a little bit weak. I mean, it seems sort of washed out, like I don't really get the sense that there's a full range of light to dark in this image. So an easy way to fix that is just to duplicate my layer, and then under blend mode I can choose multiply, and what that does is that it combines the pixels from the top layer onto the bottom layer, but that's really intense, so that's too much. That's more than what I would like, so I'm going to adjust the opacity, and I can turn that down a little bit and get it to be just exactly the way I want it. And right there, that looks about right to me. Now, there are a lot of other things that you can do and a lot of other adjustments that you can make, but I'm just keeping this demo simple and just showing you a very simple way of making a one color image in Photoshop.